Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athletes Clinic, and today I want to talk to you about why your tendonitis is not healing up. So anytime we talk about an itis or a tendonitis type of condition, that implies that it's inflammatory. Well, if you've had something like Achilles tendonitis for months and months and months, the problem is that it probably is not an inflammatory condition, but more a degenerative condition. So as we learn more about these conditions, the researchers do biopsies. They look under a microscope at what's going on in that tendon, and what they see is really interesting. They don't see any inflammatory cells. They see a lot of disorganized and degenerated collagen fibers in there, and collagen is that main protein that the tendons and ligaments are made up of. So we're learning that this is not tendonitis, but more tendinosis or a degenerative condition. Okay, why do you care? Why does that matter? Well, here's why. It's because if you've had this condition going on for a long time, like I said, several weeks or even months, and you're treating it with an anti-inflammatory protocol, you know, ice and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or maybe even cortisone, and it's not getting better, it's not going to get better because it's degenerative. It's not an inflammatory condition, okay? So how do you heal up a degenerative condition? Well, there's four main things that you need to do. First one, of course, is that four-letter dirty word, and that's rest, okay? You cannot keep putting strain and stress on a degenerated tendon. If you do, you run a really high risk of rupturing that tendon. Okay, and that of course means surgery and a boot, and you're out for maybe 6-8 months, maybe even a year. Okay, it takes a lot to heal up from those things. So you've got to rest, find something else to do. Second thing you need to think about is strengthening that tissue. So eccentric movements or eccentric strengthening is a specific way to strengthen that muscle around that damaged or degenerated tendon or ligament. And then the third thing is to bring blood flow to that area. So there's a couple ways I like to do this with my patients. And one is a passive way, and that's just using some capsaicin cream, which is derived from cayenne pepper. And it's actually used as a pain reliever, but what it'll do is bring a lot of blood flow locally to that area. So it's good to get the skin and that tendon sheath around that inflamed tendon, and will help bring a little bit of blood flow there. But what really works is something that is derived from traditional Chinese medicine, and that's a technique called gua sha, which is when we take a blunt instrument, like a blunt spoon or a piece of stainless steel, and you can scrape up and down that tendon sheath. And yes, it is as fun as it sounds. It's actually very painful, but it's great at bringing some localized blood flow to that area and helping that tissue regain its footing as far as healing up and getting away from the degenerative process. Okay, and then the fourth thing, of course, is we want to get a lot of the important raw materials into that tendon that it needs to heal up. And we really love our ligament restorer by Pure Encapsulations. Even though it's called ligament restorer, it works just as well for tendons. Those two tissues are pretty much the same in the body. They just have different functions. So ligament restorer has collagen in it, of course, which is the main protein that you find in tendons, and then it's got some glucosamine in it. And I know you think glucosamine is only for joints, but it's actually an important constituent of that connective tissue in ligaments and tendons as well. And then there are two really important amino acids that help heal up and help your body create collagen, and that's proline and lysine. And then they added vitamin C as a catalyst to get that proline and lysine to actually work and become collagen in the body. And then there's a little bit of silica, which is a trace mineral that you need also for creating better connective tissue. And then lastly, there's a couple of anti-inflammatory and anti-pain herbs in there. And I know I told you, I just got done telling you it's not an inflammatory condition, but we use a little bit of those herbs in there just to help kind of bring down the pain a little bit so that you can rest a little bit and not be in as much pain. And that those herbs are herpagophytum procumbens, which is devil's claw, and then there's some curcumin in there, which you know is a really great anti-inflammatory. So check out the ligament restore if you've got a tendinosis or a tendinopathy. Again, it's a long-term tendon injury that's not getting better. Please try this approach instead of the anti-inflammatory approach, and if you do that, I bet you're going to have a lot quicker healing, a lot quicker turnaround time, and you'll get back in the game soon. All right, so thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you again soon.